Welcome to Why Rush Racing, and welcome to round 5 of the Hillbilly GP. Today, we're at the Cassville Nationals, near, obviously, Cassville, Missouri. And, word of caution, if you're a huge fan of KTMs, you may find this offensive today. Alright, so here we are, the start. Alright, not a bad start. I'm like 3rd, 4th place going in. Oh, right there in front of me. Man, it's Rusty Dukes. Love that name, that is awesome. Alright, so yeah, hey, I'm riding in 4th place. Great start. And it's all downhill from here. I'm gonna go ahead and just throw it out there and let y'all know. No cliffhangers, all that stuff. Right now is the best it got for me all day today. And I'm losing positions all the right and left. I mean, there's Josh and Brian will pass me here going to this hill for shortly. And guess what? Still the best part of my day right here. You'll see why here shortly. And if you already saw my little sneak peek that I posted a few days ago, you know what's going on. Alright, so yeah, this is a pretty cool hill here, and here comes Brian just tearing up. Watch this. Boom. Watch him slide here, right? Here I think it is. Look at that! Yeah. Get it on, Brian. Oh, man. So yeah, today was awesome. Cassville Nationals, if you guys haven't been here before, really make an effort to get out here and try this track. It is, yeah, I'm gonna say it. It is probably the most challenging track I've been on as far as just toughness. I mean, you got some majorly steep downhills and not a lot of room to make mistakes on them. You'll see in this video. Watch my video from last year if you haven't already. And then there's some awesome hill climbs. If you're a spectator, it's a great place too, because this area, like where the spectator hill is, there's like 3 different areas that kind of converge there. Oh, there's Brian up there with the green vest or the green backpack, and he went down on these rocks. He said he literally bailed midair because he knew he was going down. So, smart move there. He's like, how did you get it? And I was like, nah, it's too far back. I was like, ah, dang it. Okay, sarah, sarah. So yeah, this is spectator hill here. Down at the bottom, there's all kinds of people cheering for you and whatnot. It's awesome. Unlike my bike, which is a turd bucket. Ah! Listen to that dog. Alright, so yeah, at this point I'm like, alright, so here's the deal. Oh, and if you haven't already, please subscribe. I love when people subscribe, it's awesome. But the plan was, I'm still racing here. I'm like, okay, I got a dog of a bike. All I gotta do is just ride smooth. I don't have any power really, because it keeps cutting out like this. But if you say smooth, don't make mistakes, it'll be alright. Well, that was the plan anyways. So yeah, one thing that's kind of interesting about Cassville is, like the trail, it's kind of fairly well cleaned up, as you could say, I guess. But man, you get off that trail, there's like these 5-6 inch rocks all over the place, and that's all demonstrated here shortly. So yeah, there was a bottleneck, like, I'm gonna get around to the left. I'm not gonna be patient and wait it out for it to clear up a little bit. Nah, I'm gonna make some passes. And then crash. Yeah. There's Josh. So yeah. I'm still got hope. Oh, so there's 2 good riders there that passed me. Oh, there's a 3rd one. So yeah, it was Brian, then Rick, then Matt. And I didn't see who that was. Like, oh, I want to be in front of those guys. So look, poor Rob there. Stuck. He just kind of spinning. Oh, I think that's Matt. Good job, Matt. Josh got stuck again. Let's see if I can follow suit. So watch my front here. Like, you're riding along. If you get off that trail, you just, oh, that guy's smoking. I remember looking over there, just fluid somewhere, just pouring out. I'm not sure what exactly, but I'm guessing it's not good. But yeah, those rocks, man, they just send you tumbling. So yeah, just watch. I'm like, I want to go left here, but I keep hitting rocks and send me the wrong way.
Oh, come on.
Oh. So sad. So sad. Alright, I'm pretty well demoralized. Still racing. Pretty demoralized. Alright, yeah, so the creek sections were awesome here. So, in addition to the awesome uphills, there's some amazing creeks. There's like three or four different creek sections. And if you race here, you're gonna come up to this creek set, this little creek drop here. It's like, oh my god, I'm going over my handlebars. Tip, go to the right here, watch, right here. Go to the right, don't go straight down. All right, that's it for me giving tips because I'm no good at racing. But I do think that's a legitimate tip. So yeah, between practice and the race, I did change my spark plug and I've been running this through my head the whole time like, what is going on with my bike? What's going on? And I'm like, ah, I'm not getting air. So let's take some of this duct tape off. I've been trying to do, seal the bottom of it. Air should, in my mind, come through the top. So I can seal the bottom. So I'm like, yeah, thank you, Dave. He said, why rush racing as we went by? So that was the plan there. It's like, I did too good of a job in it. No air's getting in. So now I'm gonna be awesome. I'm gonna go fast, I'm gonna win. So I came through lap one in 11th place. Nope, bike's still a turd. Ah! Well, here's another, probably the most challenging downhill. So we're going down, big little drops there. Of course, the bike dies and look for places to bump start. And then you gotta do this like kind of slide turn here. It's awesome. Yeah, so on top of, you know, really needing to pay attention to where you're going, I'm all the time looking for places like that where I need a bump start in my bike. And I couldn't focus on just riding. Like right here, I would not have made that mistake. Well, okay. Higher likelihood than not, I would not have made that mistake if I didn't have the stinking bike issues. So yeah, air's not the problem, spark plug's not the problem. Who else knows what? Ah, crash there. Getting pretty well frustrated by this point.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, somewhere about here, I'm going from like race mode to like, let's just not quit the race mode. Oh, there's Mark in the C45 class. Good job, Mark. So he starts a row behind me. So yeah, I'm still in that transition zone.
Yeah.
Transitioning. Still transitioning. Okay, transition complete. No longer race mode. I am now officially. And when will an hour and 20 minutes be up? Because I have yet to actually quit a race where my bike wasn't completely broken. Technically, my bike is not working correctly now. And there's Dan, and oh, I'm not sure who that was. And so, you know, I'd have a slight reason to just quit, but I don't want to quit a race. I haven't quit yet, so I'm going to keep on keeping on. And else, something else that was kind of cool. So Doug and his boys came up to me before the race. There's Doug right there. And let's meet his boys.
All right, here we are with Huck here, and James. How you guys doing today?
Great.
All right, and where do you guys hail from? Where's home for you?
Near St. Louis.
Yeah.
Okay, right on. And so, wow, St. Louis. So we're near Cassville. What time did you? How long did it take you to get here?
4.5 hours.
That's it.
Oh, yeah.
You guys are rolling. It. All right, well, good. So tell me a little about yourself. How old are you guys? I'll start with you, Huck.
Well, I'm 12. I really like to race motorcycles. I've done about a year of it now.
Okay.
I started last February. I started on a CRF 100, and now I'm up to a 105.
There you go.
I also play violin.
Oh, it's violin.
Yep, in a little minor orchestra up in St. Louis.
Cool. How about you, James?
I'm 9. I'm turning 10 in next month.
Okay.
And I've been riding as long as he has. I started on a KTM 50.
Yeah.
And now I'm on a 65.
Awesome.
And I play the violin too. I don't do any orchestras. I play a lot at home.
Yeah.
And there's a little festival I do each year at our school.
Awesome. So do you know how to play The Devil Goes Down to Georgia? You play that one at all?
We do more classical.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we just do regular.
I do some.
Like Fly to the Bumblebee kind of stuff?
Yeah.
Is that the violin or is that something else?
I have no idea.
I'm speaking out my butt. All right. Anyways, so cool. And I heard you guys like watching my videos. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah, we've about seen everyone about 6 times now.
There you go. That's why I get all those views. All right. It makes sense now. So, hey, Huck, James. Oh, Huck, what do you think about the course?
Gnarly and hard.
Yeah.
It's going to be dodging dead bodies, that's the hard part.
Stalled bikes, all right, yeah.
And my course looks very rocky.
Yes.
And there's a lot of leaves, but hopefully they'll clear out after practice.
Yes.
And lots of off-camber sections.
Oh, man, it's going to be awesome, isn't it?
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you guys out there, all right?
Yep.
See you there.
Bye.
All right, so yeah, while I was talking to Huck and James, I managed to get my bike off that hill and get rolling. So yeah, here we are, back on, well, remember, full trail rider mode now. There is no racing going on. I'm like, ugh.
Ah!
That's what's going on. Pure frustration. Oh yeah, pulling over. Yeah, and he said thank you. And I want to thank all you guys for watching my videos, and then of course the people that helped support me. Thank you very much. And back on my way. All right, so yeah, here's Aaron. I went to high school with Aaron. We caught back up through racing, actually. Hey, yeah.
Shit happens, Aaron.
There we go. Tried to get out of his way. Didn't do that great of a job.
Oh, you and him?
Yeah, I haven't seen Aaron in like...
Tell you what, if you help him get his bike, I'll hold your bike for you.
15 years.
We'll get his bike out of the way.
I'm catching up since the last... this season, actually. Yeah, this is... like I said, if you get off the trail in some of the wrong areas around here, it gets gnarly.
Thank you, Charlie. Thank you, buddy.
You go ahead. It's bad. My bike's running like... well, it runs real bad.
Mine too. I changed gears. Now I'm in the wrong gear.
It's Rob. Sorry, Rob. Rob's like, get out of the way, Charlie. So one thing to remember, if it looks hard or challenging on a GoPro, it is hard and challenging. Oh, there's Aaron again. Because it flattens things out. I think it makes it look a little faster. But it definitely flattens things out, makes things easier. So, like if you're watching, like, I don't know, go check out Ronnie Mac or Joey Mac, the short shorts dude. Those are some sweet videos there he puts together down in Southern California. So there's some spectators I was telling you about in this one area. They're just awesome. But some of the stuff he's riding over sometimes doesn't look all that challenging, but then you really think about what he's doing, you're like, holy cow, that's like a 6-foot boulder he just jumped up on top of. So yeah, lap 2, miserable, 14th place. There we go. So this is full throttle right now. Like, what is going on? Holding it open, full throttle. That's all I got. Well, I'll go ahead and tell you now. So I did a lot of, I cleaned my carb real well, checked my reeds and everything. And the big thing I did, which I think ended up fixing the problem, is I drained all the gas out of my tank. My fuel jug, drained that, put it all in my truck. Hopefully my truck doesn't just explode. Lap 3, still 4th place. Put all new fresh gas in. I still had some gas remnants, but once I got that burned through, bike's running like a champ, so I'm hopefully I got all those problems fixed. I don't have stuff like this happening. So frustrating. So So yeah, if you like, you know, people messing up, you'll like this video. If you want to see some racing, well, check back next week, because we're going to Louisa Dairy Farms race this weekend, and I'm going to be seeking revenge. All right, so yeah, remember I said about left being hard? If I didn't, I meant to. The left side's a little more challenging than the right. Shorter, but more challenging.
Oh, hey.
And there's Dave there taking photos, and...
Did you get my crash pad or a crash... I'll say, I showed you my my bash plate there.
Yeah,
right. Ah, there's Justin. The Huff. Lapped me.
Is that the first 100?
I thought he was first at the time, but...
I'm getting lapped.
Yeah.
It's ugly.
He's lapping me. He was actually second. Justin, good job on the second place.
Hey, Oscar.
Hey. So, yeah, thank goodness for checkered flags. And... thank you for watching. If you haven't already, once again, be sure to subscribe. And of course, you can also check me out on Facebook or Instagram or Twitter and all that stuff. And yeah, like I said, see you next week at Louisa Dairy Farms. It's going to be awesome. See you there. Bye.